signs of degeneration of the spine. What is the living condition? Degenerative spondylosis is a disease that most of us suffer. This is a process of aging of the spine that occurs simultaneously with the aging of the body, which reduces the health and quality of life of patients. What is degenerative spine? Let's find out. Understanding what is degenerative spondylosis. The spine is a support of the body so that we can fold, flex, twist, so that we can operate flexibly. Spinal degeneration, also known as neck spinal degeneration or degeneration of the spinal column, is one of the names of degenerative conditions. Spinal degeneration is not a disease but an aging condition of the joints. The spine at the same time develops and degenerates during the development of the body, but according to the age that the development or degradation more. It was found that the spine began to degenerate from the age of 20, then the higher the age, the more degenerative. Degeneration causes the disc herniation to become brittle and cracked, creating a mucus opening inside the esophagus, causing a disc herniation. Degenerative ligaments are also brittle, hardened, reduced in elasticity, enlarged, calcified or calcified lacustrine, compressed into nerve roots in the spinal canal or in the conjunctiva, or inserting the nerve endings in the ligaments causes pain. Degenerative early stages of the spine cause the body to lose balance and physiological curve. The second stage causes pain, tension, fatigue. According to Dr. Paul D'Alfonso, director of the Maple Healthcare Chiropractic Center, spinal degeneration is a very common disease today and patients tend to rejuvenate. The disease progressed through four stages. As long as the degeneration is more severe, it causes more damage to the spine and overall health. Phase 1. In the early stages of degeneration, the body begins to lose its balance. The body's natural physiological trajectory also changes, increasing the pressure on the parts around the spine, such as the discs, joints, nerves, and so on, that they age faster. However, because the body has a self-regulating mechanism to adapt, the patient will not feel pain or any other symptoms. If detected and treated early from this stage, the degeneration of the spine will be maximized or reversed. Phase 2. At this time, the patient may have pain, aches, stress and fatigue. Spines appear more problematic as spinal spines, narrow discs. Posture changes significantly due to lack of movement of the joints. Decreased height and spinal stenosis can also occur. This condition is common in 80% of men and 76% of women in their 40s. At this stage, treatment with conservation methods such as chiropractic, physical therapy, still works well. Patients should be aware of the symptoms to treat in time. Phase 3. For spinal degeneration progressing to this stage, you are not interested in good spine health care for years. Consequently, the body is deficient in energy, reduced in height, and severely damaged the nervous system. Patients also have limited movement, abnormal physiological pathways, imbalanced postures, permanent scar tissue formation and severe bone deformities. At this stage, the treatment by conservation method is not much effect, mainly to reduce the painful symptoms. Stage 4. This is the last stage of degeneration accompanied by severe imbalances and limited movement. Most problems that have arisen in previous periods will become permanent. Some cases of muscular dystrophy are periodically pinched, joint spondylitis, spinal cord deformities, surgical intervention. The advantage of surgery is to improve the condition quickly, the pain will be resolved immediately. However, with the risk of post-operative complications, significant recurrence and high cost. To accurately diagnose degenerative conditions, the patient needs to do some X-ray or MRI imaging. X-rays can help the doctor see your entire spine structure and detect problems such as spinal stenosis, bone deformity, or osteoarthritis. MRI scans are more expensive but more effective than X-rays because of the ability to capture soft tissues, thus pinpointing serious problems such as disc augmentation and disc herniation. MRI also helps doctors see the effects of degeneration on the nerves. From there it is easy to assess the pressure of the herniated discs or spine to the nerves and spinal cord. If you suspect a nerve injury due to degenerative changes in your spine, your doctor may order a special test called electromyography, EMG, to measure the speed of the nerve response.